loan waiver politics that's going on right now. After the minimum income guarantee, Rahul Gandhi came up with a big scheme, bigger scheme in fact, which helped UPA to come back to power in 2009, if I'm not wrong. How do you see this loan waiver politics, sir? One side, Modi is telling it's impossible to go for a loan waiver. It's not good for the economy.
No, first of all, if it's not good for economy, why did Yogi Adityanath let BJP government implement in Uttar Pradesh? That's a fundamental question they have to answer. In UP, BJP promised loan waiver.
Yeah.
If a loan waiver is good in Uttar Pradesh, why is it bad in India?
Hmm.
If the loan waiver is good, if Yogi Adityanath does, why is it wrong elsewhere?
Hmm.
So the question is, when you do it, it is right. When somebody else does it, it's wrong. This is how the politicians react, irrespective of their color.
Hmm.
So the fundamental point is, Modi government has initiated a 75,000 crore bonanza for small farmers. So bonanza, when I said bonanza, not a bonanza for individual farmers, bonanza for the BJP.
Hmm.
So because 75,000, they are spending the government money, which will directly help them politically.
Hmm.
So 6,000 rupees have been given to 12 crore farmers.
Yeah.
So obviously when people in power play politics, opposition also respond politically. They are not playing, they are not in a charity exercise.
Hmm.
So obviously Congress is also playing a political game.
Hmm.
Don't expect the Congress to play a political game when BJP alone has a patent to play political game.
Yeah.
So obviously when 12 crore farmers are targeted through its PM Kisan scheme and another 3 crore middle class are targeted by the income tax rebate with a vote on account budget as given. Normally vote on account budgets, vote on account is not expected to announce such policy decisions,
yeah,
as we have already discussed.
Mm.
So the fundamental question is, this is an election season. Everybody wants to attract. So the Congress also wants to attract the people by raising the slogan of loan waiver.
Mm.
So the Congress has an additional advantage because, as you said, Congress led UPA government has earlier waived off the loans to the tune of, if I remember properly, around 72,000 crores.
Mm.
So the United Andhra Pradesh was one of the chief beneficiaries of this loan waiver.
Yeah.
So the question is not just in UPRJ. We have seen loan waiver in Uttar Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and more recently Congress governments in Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan did it.
Mm.
And I think many more governments, if I don't remember properly. So obviously state governments with limited resources can implement loan waiver. Central government with whose financial capacity can't it not do? That's a simple question which people are asking.
Mm.
Then the question is, what is the economic rationale behind it?
Yeah.
Before questioning the economic rationale behind loan waiver for farmers, why are they not questioning the loan waiver for industrialists? Since in the last 4.5 years, over 2 lakh crore worth loans have been waived for the industrialists.
Mm.
And the non-performing assets, which will be waived if not today, tomorrow, of the big industrialists and corporates have crossed 10 lakh crores. They will be waived if not today or tomorrow.
Mm.
So why are you not questioning that? And instead of questioning that, we have seen Nitin Gadkari defending Vijay Mallya. Vijay Mallya is a nice man, he's a very honest man.
Mm.
He paid loan earlier in Maharashtra properly. Unfortunately, civil aviation business was in doldrums. And well, everybody knows the lavish parties which Vijay Mallya hosted.
Yeah.
Everybody knows cheer girls he has employed.
Mm.
Everybody knows the IPL games he played.
Mm.
So, but Nitin Gadkari is so sympathetic to Vijay Mallya. And we have seen Arun Jaitley recovering in a hospital in New York, expressed his solidarity with the Chanda Kochar and Deepak Kochar, and questions his own government CBI.
Mm.
Arun Jaitley said, CBI by acting on Kochar's is indulging in investigative adventurism.
Mm.
Whom is he blaming?
Mm.
He is blaming his own government CBI.
Yeah.
CBI operates under Prime Minister's office.
Mm.
Surprisingly, when we have union ministers so unduly worried and so disturbed when Vijay Mallya's and Kochar's have to face the law, they are not so sympathetic to the farming community.
Yeah.
The moment you give it to farmers, you say, what is this nonsense? What is this? This is an economic rationale. All rationals come. Unfortunately, we have a danger in language. The language, the language is played against the poor. If you give it to poor, you call it a subsidy. You immediately get a wrong feeling. And if you give it to industrialists, it's called incentive. If you waive the loans of the farmers or reschedule the loans, you call loan rescheduling. You feel you get a negative feeling. But if the loans of the industrialist are rescheduled, it's called corporate debt restructuring, non-performing assets, adjustment, cleaning up the bank balance sheets, it's called. How beautiful, cleaning up, Swachh Bharat. So cleaning up the balance sheets of the banks, corporate debt restructuring, non-performing asset, these are the words used to describe the state largesses to industrialists. Whereas subsidy, reschedule, waiver, the kind of language used to when it is given to poor. So we are questioning that language. So when there is an economic rationale, in fact, farmer getting his loans waived are much better economic rationale than an industrialist whose loan is waived.
Will this put an end to the agrarian crisis, sir? They're either the loan waiver or the Raitu Bandhu kind of scheme which NDA announced earlier.
The problem here is if you a painkiller can never be the cure for a disease. But however, painkillers need to be given to ensure that the patient will not die of pain. So if a person is met with an accident, is brought to the trauma care, immediately painkillers are administered before the surgery is done. So if you want, if you stop at the level of painkiller and don't do the surgery, the patient will die. If you wait for the surgery and don't give painkillers, you don't need a surgery because the patient will die of pain. So therefore, the loan waivers, the capital support, they are essentially painkillers. They are essentially some kind of an assistance. So my point is, why should agriculture be a negative economic proposition? World over, agriculture is subsidized. I do agree. But that has to be seen as a part of an incentive for food production. You can't live without food production. You can live without a mobile phone. You can live without a camera. You can live without a chair or a table. But you can't live without food. When you are giving incentives for a mobile phone manufacturer, when you are giving incentive to a car manufacturer, when you are giving incentive to a refrigerator manufacturer, you don't want to give incentive to a producer of rice, wheat, pulses, the tomatoes. So that is the fundamental logic which we are asking. But however, you need to make agriculture a viable economic proposition. So what is this nonsense in our country? We make farmer debt ridden, we implement loan waivers. We ensure that the people drink liquor as much as they can. And if the person becomes ill, you treat him under Arogyasri. If the person dies by some reason, the woman, the widow will be given a pension. What is this? Why don't you prevent this liquor addiction? If the liquor addiction, so you drink as much as you can, and if you fall sick, we will do your transplantation for the liver under Arogyasri. And if the person dies, we'll give your wife a pension. See, is this kind of an economy in which we are living? My question is, why should a farmer be in perennially dependent on governments for waiving loans? Why can't you make agriculture a viable economic proposition? That has to be thought about it. Unfortunately, long-term solutions are not thought about it.